In this presentation, we'll look at a case study for our CEO module. Your company has decided to get into the business of making kites. So you are required to perform an initial rough estimate to identify the cost to produce the kites. Now when you hear the word initial rough estimate, you should quickly think of creating a base planning object. Or you can create a cost estimate without quantity structure control. Initially, there won't be any materials in the system, nor there will be any activities in the system. So you will have to create it without any materials. So that's why base planning object or cost estimate without quantity structure is an ideal tool to perform the estimate of to see how much it will cost to make the kites. So let's look at the next slide to see what are the resources we require. Now I would recommend that you pause the video and you try to do the base planning object on your own. You have already seen in the previous presentations of how to create a base planning object. So you try and create your own base planning object. Anyway, I will proceed to show you as well. And it will give you good practice if you can do the base planning object on your own. Now let's see in the system that we have to create all these materials. So these are the required materials and their quantities given to produce this kite over here, and the labor as well. Time given and the cost in minutes per time is also, per minute is also given over here. So I'm going to proceed to create the base planning object. KKE1, it's a short transaction code. And I'm going to give it the ID. So I'm going to call it blue kite 01. BK01, base unit of measure, I'm just going to say each just to keep it simple. Company code, I'm going to specify my company code. Plant, I'm going to specify my plant ZP02. I'm not going to specify the profit center now because it's a new business, we might have to create a new profit center, so I'm just going to leave it as it is. The name, I'm just going to call it blue kite over here. Copy and paste this here as well. And then status, of course, it's released, so it's not a problem. It's going to leave them as it is. And click on this option over here, create cost estimate, costing lot variant, everything, leave it as it is. Press OK to continue. And then I'm going to proceed to fill in the rest of the information. Category, I'm going to go and select the category. So it's going to be a variable item. It's going to choose that option over here. Resource, now I'm going to go and put in the materials over here. I'm just going to copy and paste the materials list from here. Just Control C, paste it, put V for everything, V. So that's all the materials. Quantity, I'm just going to put one for now. Everything just one. And here the price total. Now here you can see price total and price per unit. So here unit, you can't put decimal places. So for example, if you say that one item of this costs 60 cents, so you must put for six items is $10. So it will calculate the 60 cents. So I have just got it in my table over here saying, for example, this 80 centimeter wooden stick is actually cost 30 cents. So I need to put as price total $3 and price per unit. The number of units is 10 units actually. This is price for units. So I'm just going to copy and paste this here. Press enter to continue. And then you can see now the total is calculating properly. 2 divided by 10 is 20 cents. 1 divided by 1 is $1. Now all my material have costed the prices. The description item should be over here. I think I put it by mistake at resource. Press enter to continue. And here you can see unit of measure. This one I'm just going to call it as EA for now, just to make it easy. EA. Then I'm just going to put two V's over here to put my labor costs. So again, I'll just put quantity. Now here, I'll just check over here what I need. I need to make a kite base. So making kite base. Kite base. Another one is making kite tail. Just put those two in. And this one, time is 15 minutes and 5 minutes. So I'm just going to put the